everyone, my name is Udit. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the design verification engineer phone screen round. At the end of this video, you should have a really good understanding of what happens in this interview, as well as what your interviewer is assessing. This should ideally then inform your preparation strategy. As always, I'm going to prioritize videos for which we receive inbound requests for candidates. So if you'd like me to prepare more content on this topic, please tell me in the comments below. As a quick introduction, I'm from Prepfully. We are an interview preparation startup that offer mock interviews with someone from your target company and role. So for this video, a lot of verification engineers from Intel, Samsung, Nvidia, Apple, Google, Facebook, pretty much all major companies that hire for hardware roles, to be honest, have been helping candidates with mocks and advice. They got together and contributed this content for you. If you're interviewing for any of these companies for hardware roles, I'd strongly recommend booking a mock with one of these experts, since they've helped a lot of candidates and can give you real-world practice and targeted advice on the gaps in your preparation. Cool, so on to the phone screen round then. I combined the video across all companies since they're all basically assessing the same two things. What's different is usually the level of difficulty and competence expected. So for instance, Google and Facebook will often have much higher bars than the rest. So let's talk about these two things. Thing number one, your technical skills. Thing number two, your behavioral skills. But you probably already knew this, so let me add real value by deep diving into each of these and sharing what your interviewer is assessing. First then, technical skills. This is typically a hybrid interview that covers a lot of ground, but usually the interviewer won't go too in-depth into any one topic. There'll usually be 4 or 5 questions asked covering different topics. Let's go through these. First then, previous technical experience. What did you work on? What was your role in the team? What did you own? Did you do everything yourself or did someone support you? Were the changes you made large scale or were they incremental? So a good sample interview question for this could be, what test bench methodology have you worked on? And things usually start off simple and then your interviewer will dig deeper to understand what your contribution was. Second type of question under the technical sphere are scenario-based questions. And here too, the difficulty level is going to depend on the seniority you're interviewing for, along with which company you're interviewing for. Good example for a graduate or junior role, a sample interview question could be, how would you connect a virtual interface between a test bench and a DUT? And DUT stands for design under test. For someone who has much more experience, say 5 to 7 years, a sample interview question could be, let's say you want to upgrade a USB driver. What methodology are you going to construct to test this efficiently? The third type of question is the language-based question. You can get asked both knowledge-based questions as well as practical questions. So knowledge-based questions could sound like, what are events? But you could also ask practical questions where you have to write code to demonstrate your practical familiarity with these concepts. Now, the most important part of these technical questions, what is your interviewer trying to assess? You've got to remember this round is typically taken by a hiring manager or a lead verification engineer, because the whole point is to filter out someone who doesn't know the job or who simply memorized answers to popular questions. Which is why I'd recommend don't just learn stuff by rote and spout it in the interview. You need to really demonstrate true insight and your technical competence and experience in this round. Your interviewer is trying to assess how much real-world experience you have, as well as areas that your on-site or additional round interviewers should dig deeper into if they progress you to the next stage. Next then, your behavioral skills. These are important. They aren't covered too deeply in this interview, but often get interweaved into the technical questions that you get asked. So you could get asked, for instance, what would you do differently if you had to do this setup all over again? To understand if you actually retrospected on the work you did, absorbed your learnings and improved yourself from the experience. You could also get asked questions around how you typically interact with other verification engineers you're collaborating with, or with folks involved in the design, such as designers and architects. Finally, you also need to keep in mind there are several behavioral aspects being silently tested even within your technical questions, such as your approach, how methodical and comprehensive your approach is, how well you organize your thoughts and articulate your answers. In behavioral questions, or behavioral-like questions, your interviewer is basically assessing 3 things. Firstly, and most importantly, what kind of person are you to actually work with? Like, are you a team player? Are you proactive? Are you an enjoyable person to do work with? So make sure these traits shine through. Second thing that they're assessing is how well your behavioral tendencies align with what this really technical role requires. So your level of organization, your eye for detail, for instance. And thirdly and finally, they are assessing your communication skills. And this is a bit of a no-brainer because this role cannot be done in a silo. There are a lot of people you need to constantly interact with. And how well you express yourself, your background and experience, how well you share your thoughts and your solutions are all being assessed here. Good. That's all then from us at Prepfully about the verification engineer phone screen. As I mentioned earlier, we prioritize topics based on whatever is most relevant for our audience. So if you found this helpful or if you have requests for other topics, please let us know below in the comments and don't forget to like and subscribe. If you want help creating an interview preparation plan or if you're ready for your phone interview or if you just want some real world practice before your actual interview, we've got verification engineers from all major hardware companies who've been helping candidates with mock interviews. You can book a session with them here. Thank you.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.